السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. We mentioned some hadith about the virtues of dhikr, صح؟ Last time. طيب. And I think we mentioned the hadith, مثل الذي يذكر ربه والذي لا يذكر ربه مثل الحي والميت. The example of the one who remembers Allah سبحانه وتعالى and the one who doesn't, like the alive and the dead. صح؟ We mentioned the hadith. And also we mentioned hadith نبي عليه الصلاة والسلام: ألا أنبئكم بخير أعمالكم وأزكى عند مليككم وأرفع في درجاتكم. طيب. The best of your deeds and also the more purified عند مليككم وذا الله سبحانه وتعالى وأرفع في الدرجات في درجاتكم, which raises you more and more in your levels in paradise, which means in paradise, and it's better than spending the الذهب والورق. الذهب means gold, الورق الفضة, الورق الفضة, okay, not الورق, ورق paper, this is paper, okay, but ورق, which surah you are reading this every Friday, فَبْعَثْ وَحَدَكُمْ بِوَرِيقِكُمْ. سورة الكهف. الله سبحانه وتعالى says فَبْعَثْ وَحَدَكُمْ بِوَرِيقِكُمْ, not وَرَقِكُمْ, وَرِيقِكُمْ. Okay, in سورة الكهف, which means فضة, silver. Which means silver. Okay, and this is better than when you kill your enemy and when your enemy kills you. Okay, they said, yes, we like to inform us what is this, or Rasulullah. Then he said, ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, الحديث for today also, one of the hadith about the virtues of ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى. يقول الله تعالى. طيب, the hadith starts with Allah says سبحانه وتعالى. طيب, what is the meaning that when you see a hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says at the beginning that Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is called hadith qudsi. Qudsi from the word al-quddus, that al-qadasa wal-tahar, the purification. It is like a holy hadith. Okay, why it is holy hadith? Because it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, when we speak about the wahi, the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have three things. We have hadith nabawi, we have hadith qudsi, we have Quran. Or let's make it the opposite. Number one, we have Quran. Number two, we have hadith qudsi or qudusi, dhamma on the dal. Number three, hadith nabawi. طيب. Quran is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the meaning and the words from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَد. This is Quran. This is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum. So the words and the meanings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. The second one is hadith al-Qudusi. Hadith al-Qudusi. Hadith al-Qudusi, the meaning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the words, some scholars said, the words from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And other scholars said, no, the words and also the meaning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. And the third one, hadith nabawi. Hadith nabawi, the words from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the meaning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are the three types of wahi, of the revelation. Okay. طيب, now this is clear. The first one is clear. The third one is clear. The first one, Quran, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, both the meanings and the words. So you say that قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَد, it is said by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, خلاص. And also the meaning. And when you come to the hadith, for example, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. Okay, it's said by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the meaning from Allah. Okay, what do we mean by the meaning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We mean, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى, which means anything from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a kind of revelation, wahi. So Allah inspired the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the meaning of إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that. طيب. Let's come to the second one, okay, which is in between. Hadith Qudusi, like what we have, this hadith. Hadith Qudusi, طيب. If we say that the opinion which says that the words from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the meaning from Allah, so it is like Hadith Nabawi. طيب. But what is the point? The point that like it has some honor that the Prophet says Allah that said that. When we say it, the first opinion or the second opinion that the words from Allah and also the meaning from Allah, then immediately we say this is Quran. Hadith could say it is Quran. We say no, it is not Quran. Why? Because there are some differences between the Hadith Qudsi and the Quran. Again, what is Hadith Qudsi? Sometimes when you read the Hadith, for example, you read Bukhari, Muslim, Tirmidhi, any book of Hadith, okay? The start of the Hadith, قال الله تعالى. Allah said. The Prophet ﷺ said that Allah said. So this is called Hadith Qudsi, a holy Hadith. طيب. Now when we say that the Hadith Qudsi is the words from Allah and the meaning from Allah, so now, what is the difference between the Quran and Hadith Qudsi? Okay, they say number one, the Quran متعبد بتلاوته. Okay, what is the meaning of متعبد بتلاوته? يعني you worship Allah by just reciting it. Reciting it is a ibadah, is a worship. While the Hadith Qudsi غير متعبد بتلاوته. Okay, what is the meaning of that? يعني now you open the mushaf, you read بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أعطيناك الكوثر, then you read again بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أعطيناك الكوثر بسم الله, and you repeat this 100 times. Okay, why? Okay, you like to reflect, you like to memorize, okay, or you like to get the reward from Allah. Is it acceptable in Islam? Yes, and you will get reward just by reciting إِنَّا أَعْطَيْنَاكَ الْكَوْثَرِ, even if you don't complete the ayah. Of course, it's better to complete the full surah, إِنَّا أَعْطَيْنَاكَ الْكَوْثَرِ فَصَلِّ رَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ إِنَّ شَانِيَكَ وَالْأَبْتَرِ. But if you read one ayah by itself, okay, and it has a meaning, يعني, correct meaning, إِنَّا أَعْطَيْنَاكَ الْكَوْثَرِ, we had given you the kawthar, it is a river in paradise. And you repeat 100 times, 1,000 times, like that. Allah will reward you every time you recite. Every letter, the Prophet ﷺ said hadith, كل حرف حسنة والحسنة بعشر أمثالها. Every letter, Allah will give you one حسنة. Then Allah will multiply this حسنة how many times? 10 times. This is for the Quran. This is the meaning of متعبد بتلاوته. Reciting it is a worship. You are sitting like this and you recite بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواج, and you repeat 7 times, 10 times, 12 times. طيب. If you come to the hadith, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما الأعمال بالنيات, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما الأعمال بالنيات, you will not get any reward because of repeating the hadith, because it is not a worship to recite the hadith, I mean, like the Quran. Yes, you will get a reward if your intention to memorize. But Allah will not give you one hasana for every letter and then He will multiply 10 times. Okay? And the same thing, Hadith Qudsi. Also, غير متعبد بتلاوتي. Allah will not reward you because of reciting it, just reciting it. So this is the meaning of متعبد بتلاوته. Reading this is a kind of worship. The Quran, not the Hadith Qudsi. And also they mention another difference between Hadith Qudsi and Quran, that all the Quran authentic. But when you come to the Hadith Qudsi, you'll find something authentic, something not authentic. Maybe most of it not authentic. Or يعني, you should study it. But do you see any ayah? For example, when you open the Mus'haf, the Quran, you find after Surah Al-A'raf, for example, authentic surah? متفق عليه? Do you find any? No. Why?
Because all the Quran from Surah Fatiha until Surah Nas agreed upon this is خلاص Quran متواتر. We don't think about authenticity. خلاص this is authentic, no doubt. But for Hadith Qudsi, no, you have to search if it is authentic or not. طيب, so there is a difference between the Hadith Qudsi and also Al-Quran. طيب. So now when we come to the Hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, or this Hadith narrated by Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala an. طيب. And they mentioned very brief in the sharh about the companions who narrate the hadith radiyallahu ta'ala. Abu Huraira, he is the well-known companion. He came to Islam, what is common in the books, in the seventh year. He came to Medina and he embraced Islam in the seventh year. And he is called Rawiyatul Islam. He narrated most of the hadith to us. His name, okay, what is famous, his name, Abdul Rahman ibn Sakhr Dawsi, from a tribe called Daws. طيب, يعني, many people, they, those who are against Islam, or, you know, who claim that they are Muslim, they accuse Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. They say, يعني, how come he narrated 5,000 hadith? شنو هذا? From where he got these 5,000? No doubt he fabricated a hadith, astaghfirullah al-azim. And also they accuse, he came to Islam in the seventh year, only he lived with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 3 or 3.5 years, and he narrated a hadith more than Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman, my sir. This is not acceptable, this is not logic. We say, no, everything, alhamdulillah, logic in Islam. Okay, so when the scholars, they mention who are the companions narrate most of the hadith, okay, they mention 7 companions. On top of them, Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, and then Aisha, Abdullah ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, 2,000, 1,000, but most of the hadith narrated by Abu Huraira, more than 5,000 hadith radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. The people don't know, يعني, those who accuse, they don't know, they don't have knowledge. Or they have knowledge, but they hide the knowledge. They cheat people. And they deceive the problem sometimes, the Muslims. Muslims listen to the non-Muslims. They check the website or the YouTube of the non-Muslims and, yes. Aisha, Abu Huraira, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. They believe the non-Muslims. Subhanallah. When we say, 5,000, it doesn't mean that all the hadith like 1 page or 2 pages. You can find some of the hadith, only 1 or 2 words. Or sometimes it is not a word, it is an action. يعني a hadith, يعني for example, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed 2 rak'ah before Fajr. خلاص, this is a hadith, prayed 2 rak'ah. Very easy to memorize. When you listen to this hadith one time, خلاص, you memorize, you will not forget. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was eating with his 3 fingers. خلاص, this is a hadith, finished. This is 1, this is 2. So maybe now if I narrate to you, maybe 100 hadith, no doubt you will catch most of them if they are simple hadith. This is one thing, يعني when we mention 5,000 hadith, not necessary that every hadith 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pages. Maybe 1 hadith, yes, full page. 1 hadith, half line. 1 hadith, 2 lines. This is one thing. Another thing, Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala, he was talib ilm. He was a student of knowledge. His job is seeking knowledge. He is not like us. In the morning we are working here, afternoon we are going shopping with family, busy, playing, and we come to a lecture once a week or twice a week. He's not like us. His life is the knowledge. And if you spend your life in knowledge, okay, you realize you will be, this is not impossible, no doubt, this is possible. To memorize 5,000 hadith, 50,000 hadith, Imam Ahmed, he taught his son 1,000 hadith, yeah, which means million hadith, or something like that. Many hadith, Bukhari, Muslim, many. So what is the يعني, strange when we say that Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala narrated 5,000 hadith? Why it is strange? And you, maybe you, you notice that some of the students, some of our children, okay, many places in the Arab countries and also in the non-Arab, in India, for example, I went there, they send their children to stay in the masjid, صح? And they stay in the masjid, they memorize Quran, they memorize Bukhari, they memorize Muslim, صح? And they are non-Arabs. It was impossible, we don't believe them. And I think you saw them, صح? Possible or not possible? How many years? 20 years to memorize? How many years? Maybe for some of them 5 years, 4 years, something like that. 3 years. Subhanallah. Also, another thing that the Prophet ﷺ gave a dua for Abu Huraira, radiallahu ta'ala an. So he's blessed by the dua of Rasulullah ﷺ for his memory. طيب. And also, you should, يعني, Muslims should be aware of what is mentioned in the media. When we say that Abu Huraira narrated 5,000 hadith more than Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhum. Wait. Abu Huraira came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the 7th year. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away in the 11th year. In the 4th or 3rd month. Hijri. Rabi' al-Awwal. Yes, in the 3rd month. So it is about 3 years. Okay? But he lived after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam how many years? Maybe 40 or 45 years. Doing what? Teaching people. And Abu Bakr, he lived after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam only 2 years. And he was busy with the battles, with the the companions, you know, 2 years. Khilafah. So there was no time for Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala to stay in the masjid and to teach people. And even if there is time, it was only 2 years. But Abu Hurairah more than 40 years. So that's why people register and they wrote the knowledge from Abu Hurairah, because there was more chance with Abu Hurairah. So this doesn't mean that Abu Hurairah memorizes hadith more than Abu Bakr or Umar or Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. Yani, now if there is a sheikh, okay, his age maybe 30 years, and he wrote maybe 4 or 5 books. And there is another sheikh who has his age 70 years and he did not write any book. Doesn't mean that he has, the first one has knowledge more than the second. The second did not write. That's it. Okay? So we should be aware of these doubts said by the non-Muslims or sometimes by deviant people. You know, from the other sects when they accuse Abu Huraira or Muawiyah or Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. So Abu Huraira narrated this hadith, Abdurrahman Sakhr al-Dawsi, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قال الله تعالى أنا عند عبدي بي. I am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying about عند عبدي بي. What you think, what my slave thinks about me, I am like that. You think that Allah is the most merciful, He is the forgiving, subhanahu wa ta'ala, oft forgiving, okay, khalas. Allah will forgive you, Allah will have His mercy on you. If you think other than that, He will be like that with you. So what you think about your Lord, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَنَا مَعَهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي. And I am with Him when He remembers me. This is the point here in this chapter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with you if you make dhikr. But if you forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are ghafla. What does it mean ghafla? Heedlessness. Khalas. Busy in dunya, chatting and laughing, going here, there, shopping. You forget the akhirah. So Allah will forget you. Nasullah fa nasiyahum. They forgot Allah and Allah forgot them. سبحانه وتعالى فإن ذكرني في نفسه ذكرته في نفسي. When he remembers me and by himself, I will remember him myself. وإن ذكرني في ملأ, when he remembers me in a group, ذكرته في ملأ خير منهم, I will remember him in a group better than his group. Yeah, this calls me dimension. This means the angels. whatever your group, whatever our group, okay, the angels are better than us. سبحانه وتعالى سبحان الله.
وإن تقرب إلي شبرا تقربت إليه ذراعا. When he come closer to me, شبرا, one hand span, I will come closer to him, ذراع, ذراع from the elbow until the tip of the fingers, which about 50 centimeter.
وإن تقرب إلي ذراعا تقربت إليه باعا.
If he comes closer to me, ذراع, I will come closer to him, باع. باع, it is the distance between the tips of both of your hands when you extend both of your hands. This is called باع. باع, okay? So, يعني, it is about how, يعني, 150 centimeters, something, 1 meter and a half, something like this. And from where the word البيع, يبيع, باع, باع, اشترى. Why say they say بيع? Because when you, usually when we do بيع, يمد باعه, you extend your hand and you shake, خلاص, يلا, finished. I buy, I sell, بيع. The word بيع, transaction. طيب,
وإن تقرب إلي ذراعا تقربت إليه باعا وإن أتاني يمشي أتيته هرولة.
And if he comes to me walking, I will come to him هرولة. هرولة, it is something, يعني very fast walking. Okay, or something between walking and running. طيب, so no doubt the hadith means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you more. What you give, Allah will give you more. What you do, Allah will do more with you. And also the thing that this is one of the hadith of sifat, the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should accept this as it came. طيب, and we understand the words of this hadith, but how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala woke, how Allah a'lam, ليس كمثلي شيء. طيب, we should not mention يعني we should not mention the way. Why? Because we don't know. يعني سبحان الله, I saw one video, والله, this is يعني, I will not say a common problem, but it is there. People in the West, they speak against the Islam, or they speak against the Manhaj al-Sunnah al-Jama'ah, against the Salaf, in English. And they are happy that they have a lot of followers. No one will defend the haqq. But alhamdulillah, Allah will defend his deen. They should يعني believe that Allah will defend his deen. When you misguide people, okay, there are people who will clarify the haqq always. Alhamdulillah. This man or this da'iyah, يعني subhanAllah, he speak about the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way to accuse. Please brothers, come, we have chairs here. Ta'al. Two here, three here. We have five here. Ta'alu, come. Hayakum. So, when he's speaking, salamat. When he's speaking about Manhaj al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, Manhaj al-Salafi, accusing them, look, they are speaking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the attributes of Allah. And also the way. This is, يعني, subhanAllah, this is not the way of the people of knowledge, the scholars. You are speaking about, okay, when you speak about something, you like to criticize, but you should be polite. Why you speak in a way to make people laugh and, شنو, what is this? Okay, they are speaking that Allah has fingers, Allah has the organs, Allah has this, Allah has shin, Allah has this. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. What they mention, not from themselves, it is from the Quran and Sunnah. So your problem is not with these scholars. Your problem with the Quran. Allah mentioned the Quran, the word saq. يَوْمَ يُكْشَفُ عَنْ saq. Saq means leg or shin. Also in the authentic hadith of Bukhari, يَكْشِفُ رَبُّنَا عَنْ saq. Allah will uncover that day عَنْ saq. The leg. The fingers, okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the heavens on finger, the earth on finger. So he mentioned the fingers. Okay, what should we do? We delete this hadith from the Bukhari, yani?
We delete these ayat from the Quran. We should accept them. If you mention these things to your son, he will imagine a man. Habibi, okay, you want us to cancel the Sharia because of your son? This is the problem of you. Because if we accept this point with him, then we come to another point when we mention something about paradise. Also, our children will think about Starbucks, or they will think about juice and cocktail. صح? This is normal, the kids. Okay, and of course you remember when we were kids, subhanAllah, when we read ayat, we imagine something. But when you get older, khalas. So he wants to cancel the deen because of his understanding or because of his way of the Mu'tazila or the way of a Sha'ira. SubhanAllah. So we to be safe, you follow the Quran and the Sunnah. What is mentioned in the Quran? آمنك. As it came, what is known about Imam Shafi'i رحمه الله. آمنتُ بكتاب الله وبما جاء عن رسول الله كما راد الله كما راد رسول الله. I believe in what is in the book of Allah, what is the sunnah of Rasulullah, as they want. خلاص. As simple as that. Allah mentioned the word hand, خلاص, I believe hand. I know what is the meaning of hand, but what is the how, I don't know. خلاص. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, in paradise, ما فيها ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. صح? The famous hadith. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, فلا تعلم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين. The souls don't know what is hidden for them. What makes their, يعني what brings the coolness for your eye, يعني means happiness. We don't know. Okay, what does that mean? We don't know. And Allah mentioned grapes, palm trees, and grapes. You know the grapes? You know, inab. Okay, but exactly how the inab looks like in paradise? Allah alam. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ said, in paradise, ma la aynun ra'at. Eyes did not see, have not seen. Wala udhunun. Ears also have not heard. خلاص, believe like that. Wallah, to be comfortable, follow the way of Al-Sunnah Jama'ah. But if you try to يعني put your mind there, you will spoil the things. I mean the mind of the Mubtadi'ah. طيب? So, يعني, doesn't mean that this person is famous or he has a beard, it means he's speaking correct. And also, when some da'i, they speak in a strong way, their personality very strong. So يعني, they force you by their way to believe them. You should be careful. طيب? So what is the meaning of the hadith? The meaning of the hadith, the virtue of dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you make dhikr, Allah will give you more than what you gave. This is the point of the hadith. The beginning of the hadith, that you should believe good about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ana 'indan 'abdi bi. Okay, believe that Allah will forgive me. Allah will cure me. Think of that. Allah will give you what you think about Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. Also in the hadith there is something. وَأَنَا مَعَهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي. I am with him when he remembers me. This is called al-ma'iyya. The scholars say the issue of al-ma'iyya, the concept of al-ma'iyya. I am with you. Okay. The scholars mention there are three levels of the ma'iyya. There is something called al-ma'iyya al-amma, the general ma'iyya, which means that Allah with everyone, everything, with his knowledge, subhanahu wa ta'ala. ما يكون من نجوى ثلاثة إلا هو رابعهم ولا خمسة إلا هو سادسهم. And if there is a group of three, Allah will be the fourth. A group of five, He will be the sixth. Which means, the scholars say, which means He knows what you are saying, what you are doing, what you are planning. Allah knows everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is called al-ma'iyya al-amma. Generally, Allah is with everyone, with His knowledge, subhanahu wa ta'ala. With his vision, with his hearing, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's not with us that he's now on the earth with us by himself. No, Allah is above the throne, subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he mentioned the other ayat. The second level of ma'iyya, this is a higher one. This is called ma'iyya al-khassa. Allah مع المؤمنين. Allah is with the believers. Allah مع الصابرين. Allah with those who are patient. Allah مع المحسنين. Allah with those who are good doers. Okay, what you understand when you know that Allah with the believers? This means what? Yes. This means He is with the believers, helping them, supporting them, protecting them. This is called ma'iyya khassa. And this is the meaning of the hadith. This means the second one. وَأَنَا مَعَهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي. I am with him when he remembers me, when he makes dhikr. So for this is open for anyone. If you make dhikr, this means Allah will be with you. Allah will protect you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, there is a higher level. This is called يعني معية خاصة الخاصة, or a specific معية with by names. Okay, يعني I mean the second one, Allah with the believers. Where are the believers? Here or there? He will be with them. At the time of Adam, at the time of Nuh, at the time of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, now or later, Allah with the believers. So this is general. But there is something specific. Like when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated to Medina with Abu Bakr. The Prophet when Abu Bakr said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "O Rasulullah, you know when the kuffar they came to the cave. What is the name of that cave? Ghar Thawr. Ghar Thawr. Okay. Abu Bakr said, "O Rasulullah, if they look down, okay, if they look down, they can't see us. خلاص. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "ما ظنك باثنين الله ثالثهما." What do you think about two? Allah is the third. So this is this kind of ma'iyya ta'al. Budathir. We have chairs here and here. ما ظنك باثنين الله ثالثهما. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Abu Bakr, and Allah is the third. So this is specific for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Abu Bakr. This is the virtue for Abu Bakr. طيب. And also there is something in the Quran for Musa and Harun عليهم الصلاة والسلام. إنني معكما أسمع وأرى. I am with you. What's the meaning of you here? Musa and Harun عليهم الصلاة والسلام. إنني معكما أسمع وأرى. I am with you. I hear and I see. Okay, what is the meaning that I hear and I see? Don't worry, I can protect you. Fir'aun cannot harm you. Okay? So these are the levels of the ma'iyya. The levels of the ma'iyya. Okay. Also, he mentioned a hadith an Abdullah ibn Bus radiallahu ta'ala an. عن عبد الله بن بسر عبد الله بن بسر his kunya أبو بسر رضي الله تعالى عنه. He passed away in the year 80 يعني about 70 years after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and his age was 94, and they mentioned that he was the last companion who passed away in Sham. Okay, the last companion who passed away in Sham. Sham means the Syria, Jordan, this area, Palestine. This is called Sham. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asking him, "Inna shara'i' al-Islam kathurat alay, fa'akhbirni bi shay' atashabbath bihi." قال لا يزال لسانك رطبا من ذكر الله. A man came asking the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "O Rasulullah, the rules of Islam, the worship of Islam, types of worship of Islam, a lot. كثرت علي. It is too much for me. So please tell me, something atashabbath. What does it mean atashabbath? يعني you grasp in a strong way. شبث به. Someone trying to leave, so you grasp his shirt. Huh?
Hold on tightly.
Yes. To hold him, grabbing him tightly. Atashabbath. So he asked the Prophet ﷺ an advice. Tell me something that I can use. And to grasp alone, yani. Of course, this doesn't mean that to ignore the fard. No. The scholars, they see the meaning of the hadith after the fard. Yani, we are not talking about the fard. The five prayers, fasting Ramadan, the zakah. No, we are not talking about the fard. We are talking something after the fard. What is after the fard? We have, for example, Qiyam al-Layl, the night prayer. We have, for example, fasting Monday, Thursday, fasting 3 days every month. Okay, we Umrah every month, for example, or every year. Okay, charity every day. There are many things. So this man said, yeah, there are many things. I cannot grasp here or there. So please tell me something I can hold. The Prophet ﷺ said, لا يزال لسانك رطبا من ذكر الله. Keep your tongue wet by ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى. Okay, yeah, of course, this is a way from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, which means that keep ذكر الله always on your tongue. ذكر الله. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gave him something very easy. Yeah, سبحان الله, والله, we need to study the way of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم in answering people. Very easy, to the point. يعني, this man, you find that this man, I will not say he was lazy رضي الله تعالى عنه, but maybe he was busy. Or maybe he was old or something, so he gave him, can be done very easily, ذكر الله. And we need to answer, to use the way of answering, like the way of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. The answer depends on the person. If there is someone who is young, tough, and he has time, give him something. Give him something about fasting. Like he said to one of the companions, عليك بالصوم فإنه لا عدل له. Keep fasting. Nothing is like fasting. Okay, why? He said to this man, ذكر, and he said to the other man, fasting. And he said to another man, قيام الليل. نعم الرجل عبد الله لو كان يقوم الليل. He said about Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله تعالى عنهما. The good man is Abdullah, but he should make Qiyam al-Layl. Okay, so the answer of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم different from one man to another man. Why? It depends on the person. Okay, so we should use this technique like the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. You should understand this person. Okay, like the doctor, the good doctor, of course, not any doctor. Okay, maybe you'll find the doctor will give a medicine, take this medicine for this patient, and for the same disease, he will recommend the surgery. Okay, why? No, this is not a good doctor. He gave me medicine and he gave my brother surgery. Because the doctor knows that you are a retired man, and you can't take medicine and you don't need to walk and you come and... But your brother needs to go and come and he needs to work. Okay, he's young, so he needs the surgery. Why? Because he needs to work. So it depends on the situation. So he guided him to make a lot of dhikr. لا يزال لسانك رطبا بذكر الله. So imagine if your tongue is dry, what will happen? Your tongue will break and it will be very painful. But if your tongue is wet, how? Allah, we drink coffee and karak and juice, it will be wet all the time. Habibi, you are not thinking about your stomach. Think about your heart, your akhirah. Keep your tongue wet by dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يذكر الله على جميع أحياني أو على كل أحياني. She said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was making dhikr in any way. He's sitting, walking, standing with his wife, with his friends. He is alone, dhikr, 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 dhikr. طيب. And also he mentioned hadith and mentioned this hadith many times. عن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنهما. طيب of course if we speak about عبد الله بن مسعود you need a lecture. عبد الله بن مسعود of course this is one of the companions, the مهاجرين رضي الله تعالى عنهم, the old companions رضي الله تعالى عن عمر رضي الله تعالى عن سيد about عبد الله بن مسعود كنيف أو كنيف ملئ علما. كنيف is like a kind of container, okay, something like and this or bigger than this, Mulia is filled with knowledge. Abdullah Mas'ud said, I took 70 surah from the Quran, from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam directly. Radiallahu ta'ala. And he was يعني, the same like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his shape, in his way, in his speech, radiallahu ta'ala. يعني, he was imitating or his way in speaking and walking like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he used to enter the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam a lot. يعني, okay, what does that mean? He was entering the house of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It means he's very close to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala an ibn Ummi Abd. He's called ibn Ummi Abd. The hadith narrated, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من قرأ حرفا من كتاب الله فله به حسنة والحسنة بعشر أمثالها. If the one who reads one letter from the book of Allah, so he will get one حسنة. And this one حسنة will be multiplied by 10 times. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I don't say alif lam mim is one letter, but alif is one letter. Lam is another. Mim is another. Which means that when you recite Alif Lam Mim, this means three letters, three hasanat, multiplied by three, 10, 30. Why? Okay, this is logic. This is not, yes, this is logic, but maybe someone understand because you know, in the Arabic language, سألقي كلمة. I'm going to give a kalima. Kalima literally means one word. But they mean kalima like a speech. I'm giving a talk. So maybe some people will think that one letter means one word. One letter means one word, and one word means a speech. So the Prophet ﷺ made it clear. Every letter means one hasana multiplied by 10. طيب. And here, what is the relationship between this hadith and this book? The book about the adhkar. The best adhkar is the Quran. The best dhikr is the Quran. And here we should notice that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man qara', the one who reads, who recites. So when you open the mushaf and you read with your eyes, this is not qira'ah. This is not recitation. Okay? You open the Quran like this. You go to next page. This is not qira'ah. You will not get this reward. Qira'ah should be mouth, tongue. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Malik, Yawm al-Din. This is qira'ah. But with your eyes, this is not qira'ah. No doubt, this is good. If you read the Quran with your eyes, this is good. Which means that you try to understand. Because sometimes I open the Quran, I don't want to read, but I want to understand. Or I'm searching for an ayah. So you read with your eyes. Okay? But the hadith talks about when you read. Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. And also there is a common mistake in the salah. Allahu Akbar. Where is your Surah Al-Fatiha? There is no Fatiha? No, I am reading. Where is your... You should move your lips, your tongue. Okay, you have to read Bismillah ar-Rahman, of course not loudly and you annoy the others, but you should read. Okay, yes, the hadith say man qara', okay, you read from a book, you read from your memory, qira'ah.
Okay? The issue is with قراءة. طيب. Then he mentioned حديث عن عقبة بن عامر رضي الله تعالى عنه. This is very important حديث. عن عقبة بن عامر رضي الله تعالى عنه. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أن ونحن في الصفة. عقب بن عامر said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said and we were in الصفة. الصفة they describe الصفة, it is the last at the end of the Masjid al-Nabawi. There was a space in the Masjid al-Nabawi for the poor people. They stay there in the Masjid. Okay, they don't have house. Poor. So they stay in the Masjid. Their life there in the Masjid. الصفة, أهل الصفة, the people of الصفة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أيحب أحدكم, sorry, أيكم يحب, anyone who likes أن يغدو كل يوم إلى بطحان, to go in the early morning. يغدو means the early morning, to go a place called البطحان or العقيق, a place يعني مدينة, like a valley in مدينة, open a place maybe 2, 3 or 4 miles. العقيق. فيأتي منه بناقتين كوماوين. You go to that place. Maybe it is 2 or 3 miles. Okay. How many? 2 or 3 miles. يعني let's say 4 kilos. 4 kilometers. 3 miles. 4 point something like this. Okay. You. يعني they say between 2 and 3 miles. Okay. Let's say 4. You go there. فيأتي منه بناقتين كوماوين. You go there, then you come back to your house with two big she camels. Okay, what is the meaning of the she camel? Mercedes, BMW. Yes, this is valuable. It is maybe now maybe 2-3 thousand dinar. So I tell you, you go there. Okay, how many minutes you need to walk to that place? 4 kilos. Maybe you walk 1 hour. Okay, you go and come 1 hour. Okay, you walk 1 hour and you get 2 she camels, big 2 she camels. We will run there, صح? He said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, في غير إثم ولا قطيعة رحم. You go there peacefully, you take these 2 she camels and you come without any sin. You are not stealing and you are not fighting any of your relatives without qati'at rahim, without cutting your relationship. Then people said, oh Rasulullah, all of us, we like to do that. We go and we walk only for example, half an hour or 1 hour, and we get the two she camels. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أفلا يغدو أحدكم إلى المسجد فيعلم أو يقرأ آيتين من كتاب الله خير له من ناقتين. You go to the masjid and you read or you learn 2 verses. This is better than these 2 she camels. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he did not say from the beginning, okay, if you go there, he did not say from the beginning, if you learn 2 verses, this is better than this and this. No, he put it in a nice way, in an attractive way. Okay, yes, wallahi, we like to get that. We like, I go there. And then he said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, وَثَلَاثٌ خَيْرٌ لَهُ مِنْ ثَلَاثٌ وَأَرْبَعٌ خَيْرٌ لَهُ مِنْ أَرْبَعٌ. If you go to the masjid and you learn 4 ayah, how to recite these 4 verses, how to, and to understand these 4 verses, this is better than 4 she camels. Now, if you know, maybe now if one of the brothers, there is a good offer, if you go to the city center, there is a very good offer. If you buy 1 milk, the other 1 free. How much for 1 milk? 0.5 kd. And the other 1 free. So you can save 0.5 kd. Immediately now, we'll go and fight for that. And if we go and we don't find the offer, we'll come back and we kill this brother. You cheat us. And because of what?
because of the milk or because maybe some of you remember before, I think 4 months, there was a problem in the Jam'iyyah with the tissue. Wallahi, I feel very bad and very strange. Okay, you go to the, usually in the Jam'iyyah there is an offer, صح? Five boxes, how much? 750, 800, صح? But this is stopped. Now you have to buy the Kleenex or Santi, these things. How much? It is 1.5 kg. صح? You know? This was the problem in Kuwait. The tissue? استغفر الله العظيم. يعني, can you imagine, brothers, sisters? This is the level of, I will not say all the Muslims, for many Muslims, we put our minds very down to feel and to talk and speak about the tissue. And now, no, it is back to the Jam'iyyah, but not like the previous price. How much in your Jam'iyyah? 850? No, in our Jam'iyyah, 950. So you'll find them traveling from one Jam'iyyah to another Jam'iyyah only because 100 fills. And his salary, 3,000 dinar. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. Wallahi, this is from shaitan. You waste your time, you jump from one Jam'iyyah to another Jam'iyyah because of 100 fils, or 200 fils, or 1 dinar. And when we tell you there is a lecture, wallahi, I am busy. Subhanallah. Ready? Almost. Okay, maybe I stop for some questions. So this is the hadith. This hadith, encouragement for attending the lectures and learning Quran, dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is valuable. This is your life. This is your soul. Dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you are in the dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are alive. You are away from dhikrullah, you are dead. Come to the lectures, attend the lectures, and encourage the lectures. Okay, we people now spending a lot of hours in something, wallahi, rubbish, ridiculous. Okay, what is the point? Maybe I mentioned this example many times. When my colleagues at work, you don't know what is in the newspaper? Well, I don't have newspaper. You don't have newspaper? Yeah, just a word. You don't know what's happening surrounding in Kuwait, this. He's not Kuwaiti. And you should know what is going in your country. I told him, okay, now, how many years you are reading in the newspaper? Okay, when I came to the, I'm working in the hospital. When I came to the hospital, from that time, 18 years, and you are reading the newspaper. Tell me the benefit, one benefit from reading the newspaper. You should know, okay, after knowing, what is the benefit? What is the benefit? The same thing, خلاص, we are in a circle. There is a problem in one country, people talk about this, then خلاص. There is another problem in another country, and we forget the first one. Then, third country, and we forget the second. We forget the third, and we come back to the first. صح? And we don't know the news. Who wrote this news? We don't know. Right or wrong, we don't know. Okay? No, I should read the newspaper. Habib, Allah, read the Quran. It will be more beneficial for you. Because the Quran is true, no doubt. Allah said in the Quran, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. This is the book, no doubt. And the newspaper? Full of doubts, صح? Sorry, full of lies. يعني, what kind of lies they put there? And of course, not everything is lies, but many, many things lies. Doubts. For the hadith, the scholars put the reference. No, tell me what is it. I will not accept the hadith. Give me the reference. Bukhari, Muslim, Tirmidhi. Bukhari, okay, I'm accepting this. Muslim, I accept. Tirmidhi, okay, tell me. This authentic, not authentic. So we have to check the hadith. And the newspaper, we don't check. No, this came in this channel. And some people, no, don't listen to the Arabs. Take it from BBC. Take it from CNN. Subhanallah. Take from the kuffar, okay. From the Muslims, no problem. Big problem. Jazakumullah khair. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.